Hello everyone and welcome back. In this tutorial, we will try exploring the possibilities of making 3D animations using PowerPoint and Paint 3D. This animation is inspired by the work of Matt Voice at dribble.com. We would also like to thank all our Patreons for their continuous support. As you might have already noticed that we are using 3D letters to create this animation, so if you have PowerPoint 2019, 2021, or PowerPoint 365, then you can find the stock 3D models under the Insert tab. Here if you search for Alphabet, then you can find a lot of predefined alphabet models, but that is not what we want. That is why we are using Paint 3D to create our own custom 3D letters for the animation. But if you don't have Windows 10, then you can use these letters. Before continuing, I would like to show you all the files that we use to create this animation, and here if I open the project folder with the preview pane, then you can see that we have saved each 3D letter of the word that we are animating as a separate file. So, let's begin by opening a new file in Paint 3D. Here move to the text section and then choose 3D text from the right side pane. Now we need to type each of the letters in a separate text box. You can choose the desired font style, size, and color from the pane. Repeating the same steps, you need to repeat the steps to type each of the letters that you want to animate. Once you have all the letters in a complete word that you want to animate, it's time to group them together. Select all of the letters and choose the group command from the 3D section. Make a duplicate of this grouped object by using the copy and paste command from the 3D section. And then click the edit color and choose the black color for the duplicated object. We will use it as a shadow. Now place the colored group letters on top of the black letters. Don't mind if they are hiding behind the black ones. Click the 3D view button from the toolbar and then hold down the right mouse button to change the view position. Select one of the grouped objects and change its position. Make the black one to the back and the colored in front. Increase the width of the black grouped letters and reduce the width of the colored. Once you are satisfied with the position and size, close the 3D view by clicking the button once again. To check if both the black and colored grouped letters are of proper size and in exact position, select both and make a group. Try to rotate and see if they look fine, else ungroup them and use the 3D view again to set their positions and sizes. As I had said earlier that we need to save each of the letters as a separate 3D object file. So, once we are satisfied with the design, size, and position of the letters, it's time to ungroup all of them. Now, select each individual black and colored letter and make a group. Make a 3D rotation to see if they have been grouped properly. Delete the rest of the letters and then save the file as a 3D model by clicking on the menu. Once the file is saved, use the undo command to bring all the letters back. Now, make a group of the next letter and delete the rest. You need to repeat these steps to save each of the letters in a separate file. When all the letters are saved, it's time to open a new presentation in PowerPoint and set the layout to blank. Go to the Insert tab, click 3D Models, and choose this device. Browse for the location where you saved the Paint 3D models as individual files. Select all of them by holding the Control key and then click Insert. As all of them are already selected, so make a group of them from the 3D model tab and then reduce the size as required. The next step is to ungroup them and then adjust their position on the slide. Now it's time to animate each of the letters, and we will use the turntable effect from the Add Animation drop-down menu. Open the animation pane and then double-click the effect to open the Effect Options Properties window. Here change the direction to up and set the amount of rotation to minus 15 degrees. From the Timings tab, set it start with previous and change the time duration to 0.50 seconds. Apply the turntable the second time and this time set the direction to down with amount of rotation 390 degrees with a time duration of 1 second and delay timing of 0.50 seconds. Apply the turntable one last time and set the direction to up with amount of rotation to minus 15 degrees. Set to play with previous with a time duration of 0.50 seconds and delay timing of 1.50 seconds. See the slideshow and there you have one letter ready. Before proceeding further, you can see in this presentation that we have applied the same three turntable animation effects to all the letters. The only difference is between the delay timings of each of the letters. As we need to apply the same effects to the rest of the letters, so I will select the letter J, and then double-click the Animation Painter. Now start clicking on each of the next letters in PowerPoint will automatically copy the same effects to those letters. Press the Escape key to close the Animation Painter. If you see the slideshow, then all the letters will be moving at the same time, so we need to add a delay timing between the effects of each letter. So, for the first effect to the letter A, I will add a delay of 0.10 seconds, and for the second effect 0.60 seconds, and for the third effect 1.60 seconds. It's totally up to you how much delay you want to add between each of the effects. We will then continue to add 0.10 seconds delay to each of the three effects for the next letter. Like, for the third letter N, we will add a delay of 0.20 seconds to the first effect, 0.70 seconds to the second, and 1.70 seconds to the third. Repeat the steps to set the delay timings for all the letters and then see the slideshow. Once you have all the letters ready, make a duplicate of them using the copy and paste command, then again continue to add the delay to the effects of the next line. You can download our presentation from the link in the video description, and if you will look into the animation pane, then the only difference that you will find will be in the delay timing for each of the letters. So, I hope you will find this video informative. Let me know your feedback by liking, sharing, and commenting on this video. Subscribe to our channel and turn on the notifications, as there are a lot more tutorials to come. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye, and take care.